the duty of an entrepreneur is to create opportunities for others. Number two is to create ideas. Number three is to be innovative.
Let's do this.
Thank God we are here again for our second PTT, Personal Transformation Talks. And the reason why you should come here is to be able to empower each other, because the world is becoming smaller every day. Kenya is becoming smaller every day. So if we don't partner, it means we can only do very little. You know, the other day I was wondering that people are talking about Kenya all everywhere, and people are saying that our nation is one of the best desired by investors. As we talk about PTT, our business here is to challenge each other. Because for me, I would hate to be a billionaire alone. Because if you are only the wealthy person in your village, every time you drive to your home, all the neighbors, they know, most of the villagers that are broke, they might plan something in the evening. By the time when you are sleeping, you hear the knock at the door. So please, wherever you come from, ensure that you empower people. That's why I challenge other people who are making it in business, that if you don't share what we do in our businesses with others, it means that very soon, you are going to have very wealthy people for you, isn't it? And many poor people. And what happens? You are going to put locks in our doors. Yeah, I hear Kenyans are buying bulletproof cars. I said, oh my goodness, this is dangerous. Today, the topic is very interesting, because last time we talked about the power of the dream. And some of you came and asked me, George, you are talking about the dream. Can you share with us some of the opportunities available in our nation? We are going to see how we can partner together. You can come up with that idea, implement it, and we shall share experiences. Once we do the sharing of experiences, I'm sure very soon you'll be calling me and saying, George, I am doing something. And for me, when I hear that you have done something, I'm going to be very, very happy. So one of the things that we're going to do in this forum is to train ourselves on how to think. How can we be able to align our thinking? You know, the immediately they announced about that we are the 7th best world investment destination, I thought it was the talk from the media. 2 days later, I saw some, you know, IMF jumping about 63 billion. I knew for sure something is happening. A few weeks later, they said Nairobi is one of the best cities to invest. Yesterday, I was in another forum. I was talking about the experience of failure. They call it fail up. And in that forum, I saw a number of foreigners attending those forums. So I asked this guy, he's called Christian, why are you attending this forum for young people and business people? He said, I am here to network. He's from the UK. So he is here to stay. Why? They have seen some opportunities and they are coming. Today I was having 2 clients from Dubai who are buying our properties. The other day the president went and negotiated 100,000 jobs to go to UAE. And I'm told the Kenyans are flocking there like this. You know, Qatar, they are going to host one of the big events. You know that? And they are looking for people from Lebanon, from Kenya. But they say, if you want workers, good workers, try Kenya. People who work very hard. And there are so many Kenyans now moving to UAE, especially Qatar. Some of the people who are buying our properties are from Dubai, Qatar, and those areas. Why? Kenyans are hardworking. This influence from other countries, we're also seeing it here. There are so many companies, Samsung, name them. They are saying we have to be in Kenya. Look at our infrastructure. This is one of the most ambitious governments that we ever have. They are talking over 10,000 kilometers of tarmac. The other day, we were rated number 2 in Africa in terms of retail business. So if you're in retail business, you are being noticed, and people are making their dollars. Look at our population. We are about 44 million. In the next 10 years, my friend, the business you are running, you have to think of how to double it. Well, the market is there, the population. They also say by the year 2030, 50% watahama mashinani, wakuje wapi? Major towns. Hiyo biashara yako it accommodates the demand. So think expansion. They also say that our people are highly educated. And educated people, they do business better because you can negotiate, you can do contracts. So it is us who are doing business, those who are planning and dreaming to start businesses, to start well. Last time we talked about planning, don't just start business in Dubio. What are you doing? Nausa Bitumba. 5 years, where do you want to be? I don't know. You have to plan, isn't it? Plan for it. If you are selling Bitumba, say in the next 10 years, I'm gonna do 3, 4, 5 times. Why not? I've seen young Kenyans going to import crappy items, big with containers, and they're making their money because they are thinking bigger, not small. Don't you know you have car? Have you marketed? Have you networked? Have you done your cards nicely? We have all what it takes. Look at what is happening with the standard delivery. You know, the other day I talked to you about it, and I asked people, how many people have got the map for the railway? Mtu mmoja tu alikuwa nayo. Nikakasirika, nikaenda kwa minister, nikaishukua, nikaiupload kwa my website. So you can now see all the stations. If you go to www.georgewashield.com, all the stations are there. And my friend, go to those stations and see how can I partner, how can I invest in those particular stations. Because this guy, tutakuwa tukiwatoa Mombasa, tunawapeleka Burundi, isn't it? Wakifika Naivasha, siwatasimama, lazima wakule, isn't it? So they need these facilities. Let's see those opportunities. And one of them is going to be to talk about oil and gas in Kenya. Last week I was reading some figures from the Ministry of Transport. We had a meeting with some guys there. And the amount of money that is being channeled in the next 3-4 months in Okisha, I think, in the pesa ya Kenya ama ni ya US. They don't talk of Kenya shillings, they talk of millions of dollars. And one time I said, what is this location thing? E or a Tukana, Nini? So I went there. And let me tell you, if you go to that camp, we have about 3,000 Kenyans there in Okisha. Kuna wale wanafagia, wale wanasaidia drilling, kuna wengine wako na taxi business, and let me tell you, one of the charities they have is accommodation. The guys are earning money there, but half of that money they are paying accommodation. Yet, George hapa na wewe mko Nairobi. Mnangoja tu traffic ya Thika Road. God help us, this is starting to reduce. It's not reducing. The number of Kenyans buying cars, every year they are buying 100,000 cars. This year alone. Last year we did 100,000 cars. This year they are projecting 120,000 cars. Out of those 20,000, new ones. Wacha hii kutuba mnanunua. New ones, 20,000. So I want you guys who are in business, go to that level. Think outside the box. You don't need money to do business. Money is in the banks. You only need a smart mind, a nice proposal, and you must be honest, of course. Then this money will just come, okay? They say that the poor people deposit money in the bank. The wealthy people come and borrow, isn't it? Optiven took about 15 years, isn't it? Problems, 10 years. But that did not stop us from going up. Your business, you will be having challenges today. That has nothing to do with tomorrow. Today, when you go Google these guys, called Kipia, these are the guys offering training on oil and gas. I went to Diani 3 weeks ago, and I looked at that hotel, Diani's Park. I told the guy, take this phone, record my voice. I saw a hotel I've never seen in my life. Clean, nice, beautiful. And I did a video. This is Diani's Park, one of the best hotels in the world. I talked about it, I midnight, bam, uploaded it. 3 days later, a guy from Kenya Tourism Board commented. 3 weeks later, the same hotel was voted number 3 in Africa. Media starts with you. If you see something nice, tell us about it. That's why you have social media. Kenya today, we have about 530 kilometers of coastline. Maji tu imetulia, no disturbance. Yet, if you go to other countries, the water sports is a big business. That's another thing. Yes, you can go to Mombasa and lease. This is a place and bring these yachts. And church guys who want to get married, isn't it? and Kenyans will train. Look at medical tourism. How come to all of us go to India? It's a high time that we wake up and say, can I select 20 people? We set up a hospital. Some of us are Occident, we are thinking bigger. You see how our law has changed? Occident, boom. We only relax when you have your own children.